Hello everyone, today I want to talk about another indicator called linear regression R-square. This indicator is one of the linear regression family, so we may combine that with the other family members as our strategy for getting signals. Okay. We are looking at euro US dollar for our chart. I'm using eToro pro charts just because I'm one of the professional investors on eToro. Okay. To add the indicator, we go here, study ones, then you look for linear reg R2, which is the linear regression R square. We leave the period as 14. Just maybe change the color and create. This indicator fluctuates between 0 to 1. When it gets above 0.7, it means that we are in a trendy market. But if it's close to 0 or below 0.3 normally, we say we are in sideways or no strong trend is available. Okay, this is one thing you can just find out straight away by look at this indicator. So if we are in a trendy market or not. Linear regression R square, I use it in two different scenarios. First, when we are in not a trendy market, for example, when the numbers are closer to zero. In that situation, that's a good idea if you use one of the other overbought or oversold indicators. I prefer using stochastics oscillators. So go there. I normally use 28 period for stochastic. You can use 14 as well, but it gets too noisy. That's my personal choice. So you can see overbought and oversold set to 80 and 20. You just leave it as it is. Okay. So this is 20, which is oversold. Then we can go buy. Here 80 is overbought. We can go sell. Okay. So when we are in sideways, it's a very good idea to use this stochastic indicator or any indicator which gives you overbought or oversold. So if we are in sideways below 0.3 normally, look at your stochastic indicator and just listen to it. So here you can see we are in sideways based on linear regression square. So I'm just going to add one line. Yep. Another line. This iterator pro chart is not the perfect one to use anyway. Okay. You can see here we have a sell signal and we are not in the trendy market yet. Then you put the sell and price keeps going down. The interesting thing is that you go into the trendy market after. So what is the smartest thing to do is as soon as you see that you are in green here, then you can move your stop loss, put your stop loss in green and or maybe you can use a trailing stop loss. That's the best option. Then wait for the exit signal, because as I said, when it gets trendy, then you shouldn't listen to your overbought or oversold signals anymore. In trendy markets, you may add another regression indicator, which is linear regression slope. So I'm just gonna choose a different color. Okay, so this is linear regression slope. Okay, so when you are in trendy market, you should go just with the direction of trend, okay? So by the time you go here, you can see we are going into a trendy market to uptrend. Still downtrend, sorry. Here we go to the uptrend. We are above zero on the linear regression slope. So here is the place that you should go last. Again, you can get the signals from the other indicators. So maybe you close your sell signal and then open another buy signal and go long. So yeah, as I said, linear regression RSquare can be used in different ways in order to generate trading signals. So the first one was combination of the RSquare with the stochastic indicator. In this case, signals will be produced in accordance with the oscillators reading between the overbought and oversold levels. And that's why only the R square remains at low levels. Low levels means, you know, I say bit below even 0.5. The second approach was combining the R-square with linear regression slope. The R-square will determine how strong the trend is, while the linear regression slope will determine the direction of the trend, which is whether it is positive or negative. And signals will be produced in accordance with the direction of the linear regression slope. While the R square remains above 0.8 level. So it's good if you maybe add some lines at 0.8, for example, here. Then here, you know, you can see it's strong trend, uptrend. So we stay in the buy position and then close the buy when we go below the 0.8. That was all for today. So you need to spend a bit of time to just get your head around this indicator and how to combine that with the other indicators. You can get very good results if you spend time and use this correctly. As I said, you should determine when combine that with the overbought or oversold indicators, and then you combine it just with the slope, you know, trend reading indicators. Thank you for watching. I hope you learned something today. Have a nice day. See you later.